Hello, welcome to my garden on Girard Street. Did you know that 1 teaspoon of soil contains more living organisms than humans on this planet? That's over 6 billion organisms in healthy soil. But what is healthy soil? How do you know if your soil is healthy? What is soil anyway? So these are questions we're going to answer today with our soil exploration. So if you are inside, come outside, join me, and I'm gonna guide you through a few activities here in my backyard. Why is soil important? It's just dirt. What would happen if all the soil in the world went away and all we had was dirt? Would it really make a difference? What would the world look like if there was no soil? All right, so for this soil exploration, you will need the following materials: 6 containers of any kind, and either a hand trowel or a spoon. In this case, it's a spork. Para esta exploración de suelo, necesitarás 6 contenedores, cualquier tú quieres, y una paleta de mano y una cuchara. So now that you've gathered your materials, for the first exploration, you will need 3 containers. 3 empty containers. The first one is for organic matter. The second one is for inorganic matter or minerals. And the third one is just in case you don't know what it is. So this is a question mark container. And if you have any questions while you're doing this activity, we'll pass out a worksheet to you that might guide you in figuring out what is what. But wait. Are there any things we're not supposed to pick up? So it's really good to be very careful with the kinds of things you pick up. If something has a sharp edge, looks like broken glass or a needle, please tell your teacher, don't pick it up. So just stop what you're doing immediately. If you see something sharp, don't pick it up. Always exercise caution whenever you're doing your exploration. So come on now, let's go and explore. Anything to do with making soil? Well, with all the ingredients that we found, we can try and make soil ourselves. So here is what soil is composed of. So 45% of soil is minerals. So let's pretend we're gonna make soil in this container. So 45% of soil. Someone say a little bit of this, a little bit of that. I'll put in almost all the rocks I have. And then 25% air. So I'll take this jar that's empty, I'll put that 25% air. And then 25% water. Oh, and my water has a little organic material in it too. 25%, so I'll put a quarter of this container about into my making soil. And now 5%, only 5%? Crazy, that's not very much. So 5% is organic materials. I'm just gonna break up this cardboard and add it to my mix. And maybe I'll add a little stick too. All right, so now I'm gonna mix it all together. That inorganic matter is getting nice and wet. Ooh, lost a little bit. It's all mixing together. It's mixing together, but it's not making soil. fixing it for a long time now, and not much has changed. Hello, sunflowers. How was the soil shake activity? Did you learn anything new? Find anything interesting? On that spectrum of sandy soil to clay soil, what was the kind of soil that you think is the best soil to grow your fruits and veggies? If you said loamy soil, like this soil here, then you are correct. Loamy soil is rich in vitamins and minerals, and then also has enough permeability to have good drainage, so our water won't just sit there and rot the roots of our fruits and vegetables. So loamy soil, that's what we're looking to build and develop in our own home garden. After we've grown things in this beautiful loamy soil, we get the opportunity to regenerate our soil. We can do this through one method that we've already learned about, which is composting. So you saw that beautiful compost that we were taking a look at, just using our veggie scraps to break down and build soil. We can also add mushrooms and sheet mulch our soil with cardboard. And we can also do this. So this is my garden bed that I planted last year with chiles and tomatoes. And now I'm regenerating this bed full of vitamins and minerals again using these plants, which are called cover crop plants, just like the ones that George Washington Carver used, brought to us with his scientific method of seeing plants that actually gathered the nitrogen from the environment, fixing them, bringing them back into the soil. These kind of plants are like sweet peas, vetch, buckwheat, clover. They're pretty amazing. They're beautiful to look at, but we don't necessarily eat them. After I planted them in the spring, they've grown, they look great. And when they're full grown, I will turn them back into the soil, let this bed rest for the rest of the season. And next season in the fall, I'll be able to plant my fall season crops. Thank you so much for joining us on this soil adventure, and I hope that this has given you some tools to build your own soil in your garden, in your street side, in your curbside, in your apartment too. You can build soil anywhere, and it's such an awesome thing to do, to be able to build the soil that you need to grow your own fruits and vegetables. Hope to see you out there in your garden. Take care. Bye-bye.